वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम धीरज कुमार साहू रिप्रेजेंटिंग द टॉपिक परफॉर्मेंस पैरामीटर्स ऑफ आईसी इंजिन पार्ट टू। प्रीवियसली आई हैव ऑलरेडी मेड अ वीडियो, सो दिस इज इन द सिलेबस ऑफ फोर्थ सेमेस्टर मैकेनिकल डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग स्टूडेंट इन द सब्जेक्ट थर्मल इंजीनियरिंग टू। सो द फर्स्ट टॉपिक दैट वी विल डिस्कस टूडे इज इंडिकेटर डायग्राम। सो इंडिकेटर डायग्राम इज ए डायग्राम रिप्रेजेंट ऑल द प्रोसेस दैट अकर्स इनसाइड द इंजिन। सो इनसाइड द इंजिन इफ यू हैव डिफरेंट प्रोसेस, द प्रोसेस कैन बी टेकन इन दिस डायग्राम। सो द एक्चुअल कंडीशंस इफ टेकन देन दिस इट्स कॉल्ड एक्चुअल इंडिकेटर डायग्राम। सो इंडिकेटर डायग्राम इज यूज टू कैलकुलेट द मीन इफेक्टिव प्रेशर एज वेल एज डिफरेंट पैरामीटर्स। So we are having two different methods. The first one is equivalent rectangle method. The second method is mid-ordinate method. So this diagram, it can be seen easily. The diagram has indicator diagram as this. Okay, you can have a look on it, and the dotted portion is shows equivalent rectangle. Equivalent rectangle means the first method we are telling about. So equivalent rectangle is the rectangle that have the same area as that of indicator diagram. If I say indicator diagram has 40 meter square area, then this rectangle will have also 40 meter square area. If the indicator diagram has 20 centimeter square area, then equivalent rectangle will have also the 20 centimeter square area. So next, if I consider this to be equivalent rectangle, how to calculate the mean effective pressure? So mean effective pressure is the pressure that will act on the engine component throughout the process. So mean effective pressure is the pressure that will be assumed to acting on the all the components throughout the process, as we see suction process, compression process, power process, or the combustion process, then exhaust process. In these four process, there is different pressure measured in the engine component. So if you take the mean pressure, average pressure to be acting on the all the components, that pressure is known as mean effective pressure. How to calculate using equivalent rectangle method? Equivalent rectangle is the rectangle that will have the same area as that of equivalent indicator diagram. So if I consider this the area as equivalent rectangle will have the area as A, the scale of pressure means how much bar or how much Pascal in 1 mm or 1 meter, that is taken as S. So the area of the diagram is A, the length of the diagram is to be mm or in any other linear measurement, then we can have the mean effective pressure as area into scale of pressure by length. So we will have some numericals ahead. So area into scale by length will be giving the mean effective pressure, that will be in bar. So area into scale of pressure divided by length. Area will be in the same unit as that of length. So mm square, that means L will be in mm, meter square, that will be L will be also in meter. So now the second method is quite a simple method, mid-ordinate method. In this mid-ordinate method, we will divide the whole indicator diagram, that's it can be seen in this slide. We will have the or we will divide the total indicator diagram into small number of strips. You can have a look on the division. Strips are there, strips are made. We will have the height measurement of all, and we will get the center of each strip. We'll have a line. That line will intersect at point that will be taken as mid-ordinate line. Now the mean of all the strip, if I tell this is the indicator diagram, it will be divided into number of strips. and the height is taken, mean, let it, this strip is has the mean height at this point, and this strip has at the mean this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. So the mean of all this height will give the mean height. The mean height is taken. The height of all the strips are taken into consideration, and the mean of that height is calculated, and it will be taken as m. M is the mean height of all the strips. So s is the spring, or sorry, s is the scale. S is the scale of pressure. That means how much pressure is indicated in 1 mm. So mm, it will be taken as mm. If the mean height is in mm, it will be in meter. If the mean height is in meter. So if we multiply this m with this s, we will get the mean effective pressure that will be in the same unit as that of s. If s is shown in bar per mm, the mean effective pressure will be in bar per mm. So the mean effective pressure will be in bar. If it is in Pascal, then it will be in Pascal per mm. The mean effective pressure will be in Pascal. Okay, so this is all about the two methods of calculating mean effective pressure. Thank you. We will look on other video having different topic of performance of parameter of IC engine. Thank you for watching.